Welcome back to In Focus, and we've reached the part of the show where we get to have meaningful conversations with our national athletes. And today, we've got two of the Philippine rugby's brightest stars joining us before they tackle the 2019 SEA Games. This is Gold Medal Quest. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome stalwarts of the Philippine men's and women's rugby team, Evan Santillan, Spargo, and Happy Denuyo. Thank you so much, guys, for being here. We are less than a month away from the SEA Games, and thank you for taking time to take this interview. First and foremost, let's start with context. We know very well that rugby is not one of the more famous sports here in the Philippines. So tell us, how did you guys get into rugby?
Well, sa akin, where do broken hearts go? So someone invited me sa rugby. Then I tried, and there's an opportunity for me to be part of the national team, so I got that opportunity.
Well, firstly, thank you for having us, Erica. I'm very excited to be here. How I got into rugby was funny. I never played rugby growing up in Australia. I would play a sport called Australian football. Mm-hmm. Now, we'd be here all day explaining the rules of that, so I'm not going to bore you with that. But in the meantime, I came over here to the Philippines, you know, to discover my roots and, you know, discover my Filipino side. And along the way, someone tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Have you ever played rugby before?" And I said, "No, but would you like to try?" And the sport that I played, Australian football, had some of the skills that rugby has now. And I was able to quickly just transfer into the sport. And lo and behold, here we are.
Yeah, and now you guys both found yourselves in the national team playing for the SEA Games. So when did you guys finally decide that, okay, this sport is for me and I'm going to take my chances to be part of the national team?
So, yun nga, diba? Someone invited me to just to train for the national team. And nung may nag-invite sa akin, to be part of the, squad. So, when I got a gist of it na this is rugby, so yun, tuloy-tuloy ako nag-training and I fell in love with the sport.
You fell in love with the sport. Yeah. And how about you, Evan?
Yeah, so what happens here, we have a local competition. And in those competitions, we have different teams, and I played for one of the local teams. And then out of those teams, we pick a pool of players, which the national team picks, and we go into a high-performance program. And I was recognized as one of those players. And it got me really excited because one of my dreams as a kid was to play international sport. And here it was, in the Philippines, to represent the Philippines. So I just thought, I'm going to throw my full puso in there and go for it.
Now, speaking of puso, you know, it's different when you play the sport just out of fun, out of passion. But this time, you are carrying the flag. So how different your perspectives are now that you are part of the national team carrying the name Philippines?
Well, for me, it's been my dream kasi my first sport was track and field. When I see na I don't have the potential to be in that team, and well, I think bigla lang siyang like there's an opportunity. And when I get into rugby, I get to represent the Philippines, and ayun na, parang tuloy-tuloy na siya na okay, this is for my family, for my country, and for myself.
For my family, yun na, iba yung sense
iba
of
yung
pride.
Sense. Iba yung sense of iba pride. Yung sense.
And how about you? You came from Australia, you come in here, now you have on your shoulders that pride to carry your Filipino blood. How does it feel?
Well, I've got goosebumps right now as you were telling me that. It's an incredible honor, and what something that resonates within amongst the Philippine Volcano group, amongst the men especially, is that we come from all these different backgrounds of different countries, but we come together because we have Filipino blood. And the number one thing that we have that we carry together that we think distinguishes us more than other countries is the puso. Mm-hmm. You know, we say to each other, like we have a chant, like 1, 2, 3, puso. And then we feel the weight of the nation, our families all together. And when we play with that passion, you know, Filipinos are passionate, they're emotional. We carry that into the game, and that I feel is our strength. And that's why we're ferocious, we play to the end, and that's what we really take into our games.
You know, puso is always very, very critical part of all of sporting endeavors. But of course, that's just one aspect. But when it comes to the technicalities of things, can you share with us how you are preparing for the upcoming 2019 SEA Games?
So prior to the SEA Games, the first competition that we competed was the Asian Seven Trophy. So this was on last August. Then after the August competition, we had next week, which is in China, that's Olympic qualifiers and the SEA Games. So we have preparation, like for the August, we prepare for at least a month prior to that. So after the August competition, tuloy-tuloy na siya. And for the SEA Games na.
Similar with us, so we just come off the Asia 7 Series, Division 1, which is a three-leg tournament. So we've actually been in Korea, China, and Sri Lanka. Mm-hmm. So we're in the top division in Asia, and we're the only Southeast Asian country in that bracket. And so that gives us a really good position to be playing at the highest level possible. So we've played pretty much, we were on the road for 6 weeks, and now we come in, we've had a bit of a break. Now the next month we have the Olympic qualifiers. Mm-hmm. So that will be a great warm-up, or just even a great tournament for us to ready ourselves for the SEA Games. So I think we have some of the best preparation we've had in years.
So it has been a series of competitions for you guys. So what kind of confidence are you holding on to now as you enter the SEA Games in less than a month?
For us Lady Volcanoes, we have improved a lot ever since. Our structure is getting better. The team chemistry is getting better. So we are confident. Now we'll stay in the podium. We're aiming for the gold, but it's gonna be difficult because Thailand is the toughest contender that we have.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And for us, I think this is probably the best preparation we've had in years, as I said before, mm-hmm. and we've got a lot of confidence coming into this competition. And what backs that up is because we've been in the top one, top division of Asia. Mm-mm. We're the only Southeast Asian country in that. So we are in prime position, and we are confident that we will be in the best position to win gold.
Yeah. So you know what, talking to you guys, I feel like I can really sense that passion that you have for the sport. So we wish you all the best for the upcoming SEA Games. And on that note, we would like to have you invite all of the Filipinos to support Philippine Volcanoes and the Lady Volcanoes.
Please support the Philippine Lady Volcanoes and the Volcanoes team by following the Facebook page, Philippine Rugby, and also the Instagram page. And also, watch our game. Come and support. Watch our game at Clark Parade Grounds.
And yeah, just please follow us on Facebook and all the updates. We show people our training camps, what we do with our trainings, and we have a few tournaments coming up, which is the World Olympic Qualifiers. So that will be in this third week of November, and you will get all the updates for that if you just follow on our page. And again, please get down and support the Philippine Volcanoes and Lady Volcanoes in the SEA Games, because whenever you come around, the Filipinos come around, we feel the puso from the crowd, and we really use it because it makes us go harder, it makes us give us more effort, and we can really want to bring back gold for the Philippines this SEA Games.
Thank you so much, Evan and Happy. Thank you for dropping by. It's been an honor to interview the two of you. It's been a great show so far, but we're not done yet. We've still got SEA Games fun facts for you when In Focus returns.